What's up guys, Stardust Yu-Gi-Oh here, so they just revealed a new Synchro card, and it's already my new favorite card. I mean, the artwork is great, but let's look at the effect. This card is called Chaos Ruler, the Chaotic Demonic Dragon, so this will be censored without a doubt. Now, one issue I always had when playing Synchro-based decks is that level 8 is a bit tricky. Besides Omega, there usually aren't many cards that are worth summoning, if you don't want them to be a boss monster. Level 8 has bonus monsters covered. I mean, you have Savage Dragon, Crystal Wing, for example. But no real good playmakers in any form, shape or form. So, this card's really nice, as it's a level 8 Dark Dragon Synchro effect monster. 2000 attack, 2500 defense. Generic materials, like 100% generic, no requirements whatsoever. And there are still once per turn effects. If this card is Synchro summoned, you can activate the top 5 cards of your deck. If you do, you can add one activated light or dark monster to your hand, also send the rest to the graveyard. This is actually insane, like... I don't just want to randomly call cards insane, but... The fact that this triggers cards like Felis, Lightsworn Archer as well. It's really strong, the first effect, so... You dig for a light or dark, so there's a lot of archetypes that will like this. Rockets, Light Swarms. But also keep in mind that you're guaranteedly just milling 5, and that's really good. There was no real good level 8 synchro that did this. There are a few decks I can imagine running this. Now, the next option I might state that runs it might sound weird, but I think Adamantipators will like this. Combined with Block Dragon, you can now just go into an Exceed, and later you can revive this by banishing it from the graveyard. And guess who can also be banished from the graveyard to revive itself? Block Dragon. So, Block Dragon based strategies that can use Dark and Light monsters, or one of the two, will really like this card, as you can just freely go into multiple Exceeds, rank 8s, without any effort, just by banishing a Light and Dark. Which, I forgot to almost list the second effect. You can banish one Light and Dark monster from your hand to enter the graveyard, except discard special summon discard from your graveyard, but banish it when it leaves the field. One thing to keep in mind with effects like these is that if you attach it as an exceed material, it will not get banished. So basically, you can keep recycling this if you use it as an exceed material. Another deck that will really like this is Red Dragon Archfiend. All the support restricts you to Dark Synchro Dragons. This is a level 8 Dark Synchro Dragon, and none of the Red Dragon Archfiends that are level 8 really do something, so this is really nice for that deck as well. Being able to dig for an extender and being able to revive itself are both are insane effects. Being able to dig for a light and dark will be strong in some decks as well. Think of Blue Eyes maybe. Blue Eyes could theoretically run this somehow, probably, I guess. Not sure how. It does need to be synchroed to use its first effect, so you can summon it with Zolkin. But damn, this is great. This is what a lot of decks wanted. Especially Block Dragon decks will abuse this and will like this. People requested for me to do a Block Swarm deck before. Block, so basically rock-based Block Light Swarm. I think this card is perfect for that. Like, it's really, really good. And I can also imagine decks like... what kind of deck would actually run this? Like, Block BA, for example, could run a Plague Spreader suddenly to go into this with level 6 like Fabled Kokias, I believe it's called. Level 6 that revives itself. I could imagine plenty of decks actually running this, and I think it's insane. Especially Elementipators will like this. Elementipators will definitely like this as it fills the grave with fuel for your Block Dragon. Or get your Block Dragon in there in the first place. This card is ridiculous. It's really, really great. I was not expecting anything like this. I really like the artwork as well. I mean, have you looked at this thing? It's beautiful. Wow, Konami actually gave us a really, really great synchro. So yeah, I can't wait to abuse this in plenty of decks. One deck you might consider this good in, but probably isn't that great in, is Infernity. Because what are you realistically digging into? It also doesn't care about monsters, just sets any card, so... Really, really interesting card. I like it. I like it a lot. Keep in mind that Hot Rod Dragon Archfiend Abyss just requires a non-tuner Dark Dragon Synchro. So any level 1 tuner combined with this still works. I guess Glow Bulb being banned makes sense now, because this would be great if you just mill Bulb. Oh, I mill Bulb, now I get a free negate in any player's turn, you know. Yeah. Wow. Just, wow, I'm legit impressed, this is really really great. Plenty of decks wanted this, Lightsworns was looking for something good to help them, and wow, this helps them a lot. It also almost instantly makes your Pot of Everest life, like if you make this, your Pot of Everest is life. Which might be relevant as well, makes Pot of Everest a better card. I can imagine certain Junk Doppel variants being created because of this. Now, another fun little thing before I end this video. The Hot Red Dragon Archfiend Calamity, the level 12, requires 2 Tuners and a non-tuner Dark Dragon Synchro type monster. This is a level 8 Dark Dragon Synchro monster. Hulky Firebrax will provide you with Formula Synchro. If you can get this out on the field together with a Plague Spreader and you can keep Hulky Firebrax alive, any deck, can go into Calamity, and because of the first effect you'll be searching something big. But what level 2 non-tuner would you run? Well, ain't it obvious? Plague Spreader Zombie. Summon this. Use Plague Spreader Zombie. Revive it. Hulk your Firebrax into Formula Synchron Calamity. 4k attack meter that shuts down your opponent for the turn. Your turn comes round again. You activate the Light of Dark monster. You have the rest of the cards in your hand. You can go nuts. Wow, this card has so much potential. Definitely my new favorite synchro, that's for sure. I love this card, it looks amazing, like this artwork is literally gorgeous. Thanks Konami for actually releasing a good synchro. I will be abusing this card a lot. Expect a lot of replays with this card. So yeah, I just talked about the single card for 7 minutes, that's how great it is. Hope you guys liked the review, see you guys next time, and I can't wait to abuse this in multiple decks. It's awesome. Starzy here signing out.